There wasn't pleasantly. She didn't like that.
She did not like that sound at all whatsoever.
So a lot of people ask me, why did I buy that car? And here's the reason. So basically, guys, this is a 2008 Cadillac Escalade on nice rims, not the typical ones that you would see on an Escalade, but I think they look legit good. This is what the previous owner put here, and I really like them, so I'm gonna keep them, obviously. And it's just a 6.2 liter V8, American V8, which sounds freaking amazing. I literally did a resonator delete. It's like this big thing right here that muffles the sound. I removed it and I just put a straight pipe, and that is the reason why it sounds awesome. Now the thing is, you know, you might be asking, why would you just buy an Escalade and stuff like that? Are you minted and stuff like that? But in reality, for the same price, I could literally buy this car. I mean, are you for real? I'm young, why would I drive that car? I want to enjoy my life. I want to enjoy a V8 sound, and it's just freaking amazing. And I enjoy every single morning that I start that beast up and every day that I drive it. You guys might ask me, why is your car dirty? Well, the reason is because I didn't wash it. So, you know, basically the biggest problem with this car is not even fuel consumption, because I put 92 octane fuel into this car, and it's 85 cents per liter. So basically it's not that expensive whatsoever. Oh my God, some fly just flew in, wanted to attack me. There are a lot of questions as well, and the biggest minus side of this Cadillac Escalade in Russia is the road tax that I have to pay annually, which is just a bit more than $1,000, and that's per year. The thing that I really like about this car is this part over here. When I open the trunk of the car, I have like my dirty carpet here in Evelina's bag, my girlfriend's bag. I have a carpet here, but there's a third row of seats, so I could basically bring anybody I want. I could be a freaking bus driver in this car. And that thing over there was supposed to be over here, but I just need to get it fixed so it looks good and doesn't fly off on a highway. Now, a big thing in Russia about Cadillac Escalades, there are basically a few of them in like this body type, basically this generation of Cadillacs. But you could find them easily, but they're gonna be all rusted, rotted away. There's not gonna be VIN codes on the frame of the actual vehicle. And it's just gonna be an absolute pain in the ass to actually get it under your name. And a lot of people, when they buy a Cadillac Escalade, they remove the back tire here and they put a propane tank in the back, because propane is even cheaper than fuel in Russia. So they drive their Escalades in propane. I do not like that, because I think gas will ruin the engine, so I'm not gonna do that. I'd rather have another wheel if some of my wheels get busted. Sorry for the dirt and stuff like that, but I gotta tell you one thing about the Cadillac leather. Okay, shut up, mate. Shut up, Cadillac, shut up. Shut up, please. So the Cadillac's leather is very, very strong. So, I mean, this car is gonna get a lot of mileage and the leather is gonna look, I mean, great. Look at this, look at this. It's a 2008 car. I mean, not the cleanest right now, but just from looking at it, a 2008 car just looks good, you know? Just looks absolutely amazing. talking about parts and stuff like that, you know, we're under sanctions right now, and a lot of people are thinking, oi mate, your car is gonna break down, your engine is gonna seize up, what you gonna do? So the quick answer to that is I can buy an engine that was brought from like Copart, from a Cadillac Escalade, and then a used engine for the Cadillac Escalade would cost me around $4,500 US. But obviously, if you take care of your vehicle, you wouldn't have to get your engine changed, because first of all, it doesn't have that much kilometers on it. It only has 140,000 kilometers. I don't know how much is that in miles, like probably around 80,000 miles, whatever. But it's all good. I mean, it doesn't even consume oil. Like, this American V8 does not consume oil, which is freaking amazing. So a big thing about my Cadillac Escalade, first of all, it looks hell of a lot muscular compared to other vehicles, because literally you have like, what is that, you know, you look around all those cars and you're like, what is that, and then you have this beast here with an American V8 that sounds freaking amazing. Now, God forbid something happens to my headlight, I could literally get that for like $500, and if I want to change the disc of the brake, that'll cost me $100 for a pair. So I can tell you one thing, guys, you know, when you press the accelerator, now that's what you wanna hear from a car. And you know, I'm a young guy, I make stupid mistakes and stupid purchases, but I don't wanna regret my life once I grow up. I'm gonna be an old man and I'm gonna be saying to myself, oh my God, why did I drive a freaking Lada Niva which had a freaking 80 horsepower engine in it, when I could just drive a used Cadillac Escalade, which sounds amazing. Everybody looks at it because there is barely any in Moscow. I mean, you could probably see like one or two Escalades a day if you drive around all across Moscow. Now, a fuel tank, what am I on about? The full tank of my Escalade will cost me around $90, and that $90 would get me through 600 kilometers of range. And I literally tested that out when I was on the road trip to that old city. So it's not as bad. And I also had a Lada before. I had an Infiniti. Now, an Infiniti is a great car because nobody even, you know, it doesn't break down. It's just a great Japanese car. And now after that, I got myself a diesel BMW 7 Series, which was literally sucking every single penny out of my pocket, and I just did not enjoy it. It was a diesel, it didn't consume a lot of fuel, but I mean, come on, I'd rather have my car consume more fuel, but I'm gonna be sure that if something goes wrong, I'll be able to start up my car and bounce out of there. Damn, boy, American V8 up in this bitch, yeah! Now, this dude is probably thinking, what the hell is going on? Like, look, I can literally slow down and look at those guys. They're gonna turn. Oh, yeah. Now, they might have not physically turned, but I gotta tell you one thing, guys. If they turned, I mean, my car turned their souls. It turned their souls. I mean, I just love this car. I mean, an American V8 is just such a great engine. I would love to get myself like I don't know, Chevrolet Corvette Stingray 1969, which would be freaking amazing. Now, you know, American cars are great. It feels like they actually have a spirit in them. Like, literally, what car, like all the modern cars, right? With their all modern eco-friendly engines, with like gazillion turbochargers, it just doesn't feel like a freaking V8. You know what I mean? It's a 6.2 liter V8 with 402 brake horsepower. Now that is like a freaking train. So basically, I could load up the whole back with a bunch of people, bags of potatoes, I don't know, watermelons, whatever, and it's still gonna haul some ass for definite. Now guys, I know this isn't my typical vlog, it's just because I was literally in my house all day and I had nothing to do, but I was like, you know, I'm getting a lot of questions about my Escalade, so hopefully I answered those questions. If you enjoyed this type of my video, I guess, you know, just click the like button, subscribe, and comment in the comment section below if you would like me to do some crazy random reviews of cars just like this. See you later, boys.